We are going to continue with our fractions this week. We're going to be dividing these circles right now. When dividing shapes into fractional parts, the parts must be equal size portions. They must all be the same size. So we have three circles here. This circle is divided into two equal parts or halves. There's two halves here. Line is down the middle. This circle is divided into three equal parts, so all of these pieces are equal. They're about the same size. This is also called thirds. The circle is divided into four equal parts. They're all the same size, or fourths. So this one is in halves. Repeat after me, halves. This one is in thirds. Repeat, thirds. And this one is in fourths. Can you say fourths? Perfect. It's got that TH on the end, so it's a four with a th on the end. I know it's a little weird, huh? Okay. So if you look at these, the square below is not divided into equal parts because the parts are not the same size. So this does not show fourths. It has to be equal. See how this one's real tiny and this one's real big? Those are not equal parts. So that does not show fourths. This square, however, is divided into equal parts. All of these look to be about the same size, so it is divided into fourths. Okay, let's look at these stars. To show fractions in length, you can show sets of the same shape and size. The picture above shows a set of stars. They are all the same size and shape. Two of the four stars are shaded, so this picture shows the fraction 2/4. Okay, let's look at our square here. An area model, that's what this is called. An area model is shown usually by a square with an equal part shaded. So there's four equal parts here. They're all about the same size. One is shaded in. The area model above has one square shaded out of four. The fraction is 1/4. Okay, you'll need your whiteboard for these. Here's the first one. Draw the circle and divide it into two equal parts. That's from the very beginning of the video. You can do that. Pause, draw a circle, and make two equal parts. So did yours look similar to this? If you put the line going horizontally, that would have been okay too, because they're going to be equal top and bottom. But I did it side to side, just like our example from the top. Is that what yours looks like? If so, good. Let's try the next one. Color one half of the circle in question one. So go ahead and color one half of the circle that you drew. That was easy. You just colored one part of it. Okay, the next one. Draw a square and divide it into three equal parts. How can you divide a square into equal parts that are only three, not four? Give it a try right now. Okay, is your square similar to this? We have three equal parts there, or close. I know sometimes it's hard to draw freehand, but that's basically how you could do it, or you could have made them going horizontally the other direction. Color 2/3 of the square in question three. 2/3 of them. So how many will you color? Pause it and color in what you need to color. So you should only have two of the three colored in. Is that how you did yours? If so, you did it perfect. Okay, it says color one of the set below and write the fraction it represents. So if we color this one in purple, I'll just kind of scribble it in because it will take a long time for me on this computer to color this in. So we have one colored in. We have one, two, three, four. Write the fraction that this represents now. What would it be? Pause it and write it on your whiteboard, and then unpause it to check your answer. Did you write down 1/4, 1/4? Because that is the correct answer. We have one shaded in, that's the numerator on top, and the total, 1, 2, 3, 4, the total is the denominator. It goes on bottom. Okay, our next one, draw a rectangle and divide it into four equal parts. So pause it and do that now. I drew my lines horizontally. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 now, 4 equal parts. And now it wants us to color in 3 of those 4 parts, so 3/4 of it. So if we colored these in, I just kind of have to scribble because it's really hard to draw and color on the computer like this. But you color yours in. So color yours in right now. You want to color in 3/4 of it. So we're just coloring in 3 boxes, right? So 3/4. Perfect.